I want you to pause for just a moment. Before we even get started with the content today, I want you to think about how you desire the rest of your life to be. Living life as vitally as you desire, or living life by the armchair or the couch? The choice is up to you. In the end tonight, we're going to be talking about lifetime care. Now, for some of you, this is a very new conversation. This is a very new idea. For others of you, you recognize the fact that this is something that you've been engaging in one way or the other throughout your entire lifetime. But tonight, we're going to pose the question, what are the things that you need to change to make sure that that lifetime care that you're providing is the best lifetime care that you need? Now listen, some of us, we've lived the lie. If it's not broke, don't fix it. If there's no pain, there's no problem. Heck, you suck it up. You live with it long enough, eventually it's going to go away. Ignore it. Don't worry. It'll just go by the wayside. Now, have any of you guys heard that? Because I can remember my coaches, my athletic coaches, my gym teacher, and so many others saying that again and again and again. Just shake it off, it'll go away. See, the problem is that all of these are lies. And throughout our lifetime, we've heard these lies again and again and again. And for some of us, we started to live those lies in so many different ways. And the sad thing is that in the end, this is not a chiropractic conversation. But in the end, this is a health care conversation. Your health care. You know, as we look at this, we look at the fact that ultimately our health care is all about us making better choices. And, you know, these are just a couple of different areas, whether we're talking about diet and nutrition and vitamins or exercise or your chiropractic care. These are all choices. They're all choices and they're all decisions that are unique for each and every one of us. What I choose for me might be different than you choose for you. But in the same respect, we have to ask ourselves, what's the quality of the decision that we just made for the overall health and function of our body? Now, sadly, some of us don't recognize that, you know, because of the lies that we've been told, what we've been marketed to our entire lives, we've bought into the fact that, hey, listen, zero fat means I'm healthier. Zero sugar means that it's better for me. You're going to come to find out that, you know, as you listen to different workshops on drink this and not that, on heart health and different conversations that we have about diet and nutrition, about making better food choices, guess what? What seems to be so obvious, things that we've been told again and again and again, were just simply lies. Because no, zero fat doesn't mean that it's great for us. No calories doesn't mean that it's the healthy choice. We recognize that these are the lies that each and every one of us have been listening to. And for some of you out there, you're so new to this conversation that some of these are just so difficult to obviously grasp a hold of. I'm going to encourage you, ask questions. In the comment section below, ask those questions. Ask the questions about, you know, the soda or the drink of choice. Is this a good choice for me? Let's talk about, you know, the pros and the cons of making different choices. Is gluten-free something that I should be considering? The wonderful thing is that we have a whole library of information that we could talk about and dig into that's based on fact and truth, and not on marketing. There's a gentleman, his name was Adolf Hitler. Maybe you heard of him. He's noted as saying, if you tell a lie enough times, eventually they're gonna believe it to be true. And in the end, listen, the process is that we have drive the outcome that we get. And health is not a project that we choose. It's not like building a house where, hey, listen, you know, you hit the last nail, you put that last piece of molding on, and you're finished with the project. That's not it. Our health is a process. Every day we renew with the decisions that need to be made. Do I get up and move my body? Do I drink water first before anything else? You know, do I add cream and sugars into my coffees? Do I consume things like alcohol during the course of the days? These are all choices. And let's not forget, it's not a matter of just what we're putting into our body, but mechanically how we set our body up. Am I making sure that my workstation is ergonomically correct? Am I listening to things that are building me up or breaking me down? In the end, these are all things that add to the process. And every little thing matters. Every little thing counts. Because unfortunately, we are greater than the sum of our parts. In other words, if we're neglecting one part of our system, that's not health. That's not us making healthy choices. Jim Fex was one of those gentlemen who was noted as saying, hey, listen, I can eat whatever I want to eat as long as I'm running on a regular basis. And Jim Fex was the father of modern running. He was one of those individuals who made it so popular to run on a regular basis. He was also the individual that was found on the side of the road dead of a heart attack. We realize that, you know what, these truths, they'd hold true across time. And if we neglect one system by making poor choices, those poor choices will produce bad outcome for our health. And listen, in the end, our health is the easiest thing to maintain, but it is one of the hardest things to recover from. And anybody who's had a serious illness, a serious injury, knows how long it takes to overcome and rebuild this system of ours. We're blessed. Our body is so very willing to change, but it's so unforgiving when we damaged it. So let's recognize that, you know, every one of these decisions are capable of creating drastic outcomes if we repeat it again and then again and again. And listen, when we're talking about lifetime care, you can stop whenever you want to. Patients always ask, hey doc, how long do I have to show up and get adjusted? Listen, you can stop today. It's okay. You might want to use the same argument with your dentist. Hey doc, when do I get to stop brushing my teeth? When do I get to stop flossing and water picking? When do I got to stop doing these things? He'll tell you, listen, it's a choice. You could stop today. You get to visibly see your teeth rot, decay, and fall out right in front of your eyes. Because every day that you choose not to engage in maintaining the health of those teeth, guess what? You allow for greater levels of continual breakdown to occur. Well, in the end, your spine is exactly the same. The only difference is we don't get to see the damage that we're creating and accumulating within our spine. And unlike our teeth, which, hey, listen, dentures and implants are capable of reproducing what your body was given naturally, not nearly to the same, you know, positive degree, but they're functional. But sadly, within our spine, we can't reproduce what's been given. Once we lose the function of those joints, once we've destroyed those, there's no remaking that again. We're stuck with those damages, and that's not okay, because those damages last us a lifetime. There's no reversing that. In fact, in life, listen, let's be honest, the only time that we actually get to coast is when we're going downhill. Your body's sort of like a car. Last time I checked, my car didn't coast uphill. I wish it did. With the price of gas today, the price of diesel today, guess what? I wish it would coast uphill. Doesn't happen, does it? Oh no. The only time it coasts are when we're going downhill, when gravity is constantly pushing us downward. And listen, our body is exactly that way. It feels so good, you know what, as we're consuming all the foods that we want, as we're consuming the different things, as we're sleeping in different positions, or maybe slouching over as we're working on the computer or looking at our cell phone. Gravity wants to push us down. It's a downward force. Guess what? Our body is more than willing to go downward. But when we try and turn it around and start climbing that hill back to that better function and that better health, we get to experience the uncomfortableness of regaining that level of health that we're supposed to be at. Oh no, you could ride the hills and, you know, into the valleys, but just recognize, if we ever want our body to function at that optimal level, it's going to take a lot of work and a lot of effort in order to get it back to that easy level of maintaining and supporting, so our body's working at an optimal level. And, you know, when we talk about maintaining, the health of our body goes beyond just the physical nature. Hans Selye, back in the 1950s, he was thrown out of his own medical society because he taught that thought preceded reality, that thought influenced what happened to reality. In other words, if you could think it, you could be it. Yes, Walt Disney was not the first person to come up with this. And here's the thing. Today we recognize energy precedes thought. Thought precedes reality. See, what we think in our mind, how we feed our body, you getting this educational information, are those things that positively motivate the body to move in that better, healthier direction. It's been demonstrated through research with, you know, everything from, you know, music to so many other components like electric EMS that, you know, have a negative effect or a positive effect on things in nature. We see that all the time. Research has already been done. We don't have to reproduce all this. We recognize that, you know what? What we think we eventually become. And in turn, certainly one of those things that we get to choose the things that we are feeding our brain. See, unfortunately out there, when we're listening to media, we get to hear about all the next crazes. The next Atkin diet, the next zero fat, zero calorie. You know, you can just use this chemical to substitute for your immune system. We get to hear about all of those things. And they're all shortcuts to doing the hard work that's necessary to maintain our body, to maintain our health. And in the end, let's be honest, each one of those shortcuts comes with a price that we're going to pay. There isn't a commercial out there for a drug that doesn't end with, you know, them listing off at least a half a dozen, if not more, different side effects to those drugs and medications. And we recognize those poor choices, engaging in things that aren't lifting the body up, that bring more things, more problems for us to handle, those poor decisions happen to be the leading cause of death in the United States. The research has already been done. It's not cancer, it's not tumors, it's not heart disease. It's poor decision making. And in the end, we realize that each of us has on a daily basis the responsibility to make those better choices. And I love this. The quality of our lifetime care is what you choose for yourself. See, I love this. Because in the end, we have to pat ourselves on the chest. We have to poke ourselves in the middle of our chest in order to make sure that we're reminding ourselves that ultimately it's our responsibility. It's our choice. So often, you know, as I talk to male patients about, you know, their food choices and about the things that they consume and how they eat and feed and fuel their body, I always hear the same excuse. My wife cooks it and I eat it. My wife cooks it and I eat it. I have to eat it. It's like, well, let me tell you, nobody stands over top of you shoving food down your throat, you know. We have male patients in the office, 6'2", 6'5", you know, 250 pounds. Guess what? Nobody's standing on top of them and force-feeding food down their throat. You're not a two-year-old. This is not an airplane move that, you know, gets you to open your mouth to, you know, fill it with food. That's not it. So in the end, there are no excuses. In the end, let's recognize the fact that everything that we do, everything that we put into our body and onto our body happens to be a choice. And those choices influence the lifetime care that we choose for ourselves. In fact, tonight, the one big thing that we have to choose is what we desire for ourselves. We get to choose that. Whether it's our workstations that we have in setup, whether it's the exercises that we choose to either do or not do, all of these different things are a choice for you and I. For many of you, if you're a patient here at the Limerick Chiropractic Center, you most likely already have a series of exercises, or maybe just those one or two exercises that you're responsible for your posture, for your mirror image work. Maybe you have, you know, tractioning that you're responsible for doing at home. For those of you who aren't patients here at the Limerick Chiropractic Center, listen, you know, you getting up and out and moving your body, it is a choice. And we need to move our body on a regular basis. But every day happens to be a choice. So we realize that, you know, in the end, the choices that we make will influence us greatly. I desire for you to have the greatest quality of health for the rest of your life. You know, we start our relationship out here at the Limerick Chiropractic Center by asking one very important question at the end of our examination day. What's the one thing that you're not capable of doing now that you desire to be able to do again? What's that one thing that you haven't been able to do because you've had this obstacle, this stumbling block in your way? I'm going to ask you guys tonight, as we're finishing up this workshop, in the comment section below, I want you to write your one thing. That one thing that you really are looking forward to getting back to again. That one thing that defines for you that next step that you want to be taking. What is it? As always, I ask you guys to like this video. One of the reasons is so that we can get this video out to more individuals to help them learn about how to make better choices. And then finally, you sharing this video amongst your Facebook friends, make sure that people who maybe would have never heard this message have that opportunity of about hearing about lifetime care. I'm Dr. Joseph Baker from the Limerick Chiropractic Center.